I'm Sathish Kumar and welcome to my talk title, Effect of Broadband Gain Frequency Shaping on Horizontal Localization Performance in Individuals with Normal Hearing. The ability to localize the sound source is important for tasks such as spatial awareness, orienting oneself towards the target speaker, and detecting the warning signs. And this will be conveyed to through the spatial cues, intraoral time difference or intraoral phase difference, and intraoral level difference. Previous research studies have evidenced that the spatial hearing ability is affected in individuals with hearing impair compared to normal hearing individuals. And to compensate for the loss of audibility, the fitting of bilateral hearing aids is a common practice among the audiologists. But even with the fitting of bilateral hearing aids, restoring the spatial hearing ability is challenging. Moreover, the localization abilities are better without the hearing aid than with the hearing aid. And this particular trend is observed even in normal hearing individuals when fitted with the bilateral hearing aids. Numerous research studies have developed and evaluated algorithms to preserve the spatial cues in hearing aids, such as inter-ear coordinated compression and pinna compensation algorithms, but most of them showed mixed results. In our study, we evaluated one of the overlooked factor in hearing aid signal processing is filter interaction related artifacts, otherwise called as interference. Ideally, when you use two or more filters, the combined frequency response magnitude of the filter should be flat in the absence of interference. But the interference at the filter output is unavoidable, particularly when two or more overlapping adjacent filters are used. The interference in the IR filter is well known, where the combined magnitude frequency response of the filters has peaks and valleys, which is due to the characteristics of IR filter, where the group delay varies across the frequencies. The above mentioned factor can be overcome by using FIR filter, but the interference still persists depending on the characteristics of the filter ripples. This plot, the gray line represents individual filter frequency response and the red one indicates the combined magnitude frequency response. As you can see, when only four filters are used, the combined magnitude response is almost flat, indicating less interference. But as the number of filter increases, the combined magnitude is no more flat, indicating there is a large interference due to interactions between the adjacent filters. Even though less number of filters produce less interference, it cannot be used in hearing aids because we need adequate number of filters to provide frequency specific amplification. In the same way, here higher order filters have a less interference compared to the lower order filter, which is due to reduction in the ripple magnitude in the higher order filter and increase in the steepness of the filter slope in the higher order, which causes less interaction between the adjacent filter. Even though high filter order introduces less interference, it requires more computational power, which makes them not suitable for real-time applications. So there is a need for trade-off between the number of filters and filter order for efficient implementation in hearing aid algorithms. In our study, we have proposed a broadband gain frequency shaping method by introducing a single filter in the low frequency where there is a more filter interaction, as you can see here. To provide frequency specific gain, the broadband filter is designed using FIR2 function in MATLAB, where the filter magnitude is no need to be flat and which can be specified based on our needs. And in the current study, we aim to evaluate the effect of broadband frequency shaping on horizontal localization performance. So here we have three conditions, which is SF0, which don't have any broadband filter, and SF300 will have broadband filter between 100 to 300 Hz, and SF1000, which will have broadband filter from 100 to 1 kHz. Six individuals with normal hearing recruited for the current study, and their horizontal localization performance was evaluated using 19 speakers placed between minus 90 to plus 90 azimuth, and 200 millisecond broadband noise was used as a auditory stimulus. Initially, the audio signals were pre-recorded using two miniature microphones to capture the individual HRTF, then the recorded signal used for hearing aid signal processing as mentioned in this framework. So the gain and compression parameters was calculated based on NAL NL2 prescriptive formula with the attack and release time of 5 and 70 milliseconds. Finally, the processed signal presented to the subject using IP30 insert earphones. Based on the experimental condition, the bandpass filter bank will be replaced by three variations of broadband filters as mentioned before, SF0, SF300 and SF1000. Total we have six experimental conditions in the current study. First one is UEA, that is unaided, that is the stimulus directly present from the loudspeakers, and UAI is just unprocessed hearing aid microphone recorded signals. And aided we have used a commercially available RIC hearing aid and three variations of broadband filters. The data collected from the localization experiment, the root mean square localization error and the sign bias will be calculated using this formula. For objective analysis, we have used the Oldenburg HR2 database to spatialize the audio signal, and the spatialized stimulus is streamed to the commercial hearing aid via Bluetooth. The output of the processed spatialized signal was recorded using 2cc coupler for further analysis. The ITD and intraoral coherence was calculated using a cross correlation method using this formula. And ILD is just the intensity difference between left ear signal and right ear signal. To evaluate the ongoing ITD and ILD changes within the stimulus, the auditory model developed by Dietz et al. Was used. Here the sound direction estimation was calculated using predetermined ITD and ILD maps for different azimuths. This is an example of a model output. Here the peak of the data corresponds to direction of arrival. So in this case it's 60 degree and this case it's 40 degree. And the narrow width indicates there is a high confidence in the direction of arrival, and broad data indicates there is less confidence. The repeated measures of ANOVA and post-hoc analysis indicates that the root mean square localization error is more for the aided condition compared to the unaided condition, and there is no significant difference observed for any other combinations for both RMS error and sign bias. Here is the additional data collected in our lab on hearing impaired participants who have a bilateral mild to moderately severe sensory neural hearing loss. Again, here also there is no significant difference between unaided and other broadband filtering condition. This is the results of objective analysis for intraoral time difference. Here the circle symbol indicates the original signal and square is for a commercial hearing aid, and the diamond symbol for broadband filtering condition, and first panel for SF0, SF300, SF1000. So as you can see here, the broadband and original signal or results are close to each other, but the commercial hearing aid is not, and this is same for across the broadband filtering condition. This is the waveform ITD for 1 kHz 1/3 octave filtered signal, and this is envelope ITD for 4 kHz, and the same trend observed for even intraoral level difference. As you can see here, for 1 kHz and 4 kHz, and followed by same thing for intraoral coherence for 1 kHz and 4 kHz. The results of auditory model indicates that all the broadband filtering conditions are close to the results of the original signal. But however, the green one is the commercial hearing aid, which deviates from the original signal results, and the data observed to be more broader than the original signal, as you can see in 45 degrees and 30 degrees. To summarize, the localization performance was poor in the aided condition, that is commercial hearing aid, compared to the unaided condition. And the localization performance of all the conditions used our experimental hearing aid with or without broadband filter showed similar scores compared to the unaided condition. So regardless of filter interaction, the hearing aid algorithm used in the current study preserves the spatial cues compared to the commercial hearing aid. How? So even though there is a positive results, providing reasons for such kind of results is challenging because the details of signal processing used within the hearing aid is not publicly available. However, we speculate three possible reasons for our findings. So first one is less distortion produced in the filter bank output due to the use of FIR filter. The change observed in the combined magnitude frequency response can be due to the constructive interference, where the signals from the adjacent filter were in phase so that they can just add it up and nothing gets cancelled out. Second reason, better preservation of ITD cues due to the use of higher sampling rates. Human ITD perception can have infinite precision and highly dependent on individual characteristics. In case, if the signal have a ITD of 3 microsecond, the sampling rate of 100 kHz can capture this ITD information because it samples at every 1 microsecond interval, but 44.1 kHz sampling rate detected as 2.2 microsecond because it samples at every 2.2 microsecond, and it is even worse for lower sampling rates such as 24 kHz, where it detects as 4.1 microsecond. This plot shows the variation in accuracy of capturing ITD information for different sampling rates. Third, the usage of extended low frequency amplification by our hearing aid algorithm, that is from 100 Hz. And most of the commercially available hearing aids don't offer such low frequency amplification, which has the dominant ITD informations. Because of these reasons, the hearing aid algorithm used in the current study preserves the spatial cues better. Thank you for listening.